Hey everyone, welcome back. So in the last video we learned about navigation in an INX 5 application, and what we did, we created a second product descriptions page where the user will be taken to if he clicks on any item in the list. Let's see. So this is our list, and these are all items, and if we click on any one item, we will be directed to a second product descriptions page. Now this is a separate page in our application. The first page is the home page from where we navigated to, and if we want to go back to the home page, we have to press this back button and we will come back to the home page. So this is what we achieved in the last video. In this video we are going to build this product descriptions page. We have to show the data of the product that we have clicked upon on this page. For example, if I click on Energizer, and when I click here, I will be taken to product descriptions page, and here I have to show the details of the Energizer product. So let's get started. This exercise is divided into three steps. The first step is to fetch this ID that we have sent over the URL. Second, we have to use this ID to hit the API and get the data about that particular product whose ID is 150115 or whatever is coming through the URL. The third step will include the displaying of the data on this page using an IN card UI component. So these are the three steps that we will be following to display the data of the product on this particular page. In fact, what we are going to do, we are going to first learn about IN card and then fill it with some dummy data, and later on we will fetch the data over the API using this ID and arrange it properly and nicely over that IN card. So let's get started. So here is our code, and our terminal is running fine. Let me minimize it so that we can see the code as well as the implementation. And what we are going to learn, we are going to learn about IN cards. So let me open it up, and here is our IN card. Let me maximize it a bit. Okay, here we are. So cards are a standard piece of UI that serves as an entry point to more detailed information. So this is what we actually need, more detailed information. A card can be a single component, but is often made up of some header, title, subtitle and content. Let me maximize it so that you can see here. This is a card. This whole is a card. It is a small box or rectangular box that is displayed over the screen, and it gives it a feeling of elevation, and it actually groups some components and show it to us. So it is a good UI. Actually I like IN card very much because it is gives a good presentation of the data. And IN card is broken up into several sub components to reflect this. Please see IN card content, and okay, here there are a lot of things. So let's get started with some coding. And what we'll do, we will just after this description we have the usage, and let's open the Angular code, and here it is. See, one thing I want to show you. See, cards are a standard piece of UI, and a card can be a single component, but is often made up of some header, title, subtitle and content. Now see what it is written. Often made up of. It means usually it has a header, title, subtitle and content, but not always. We cannot say that IN card will definitely have a header, title, subtitle and content. It can have them or it can not have them, whatever. So let's see the usage now. So this is an IN card. Let me maximize it. An IN card, it contains a IN card header and subtitle and title, and the header is closed, and then we have the content. Let me just copy this part and paste it here. This is our code, and let me just remove this IN label here and paste this one. Control Shift I to format the code. It's almost already formatted. See, it is an iron card tag starting and closing. Inside it has iron card header, iron card subtitle, and I think this title is here. Okay, so let it be. Let's see how it looks on the UI. Let me just minimize this explorer, because we are going to again work on a single file, that is product details page.html. I have not yet saved it, and this is our page, and let me save it now. And as I save it, nothing has happened. And why nothing has happened is our, it's working fine. Let me run it once again and observe. Let me pause the video for a sec. So guys, welcome back. So there was some problem while running the code. I just killed the process and ran the server again, and here is our iron card. In order to, if you are not able to see it, let me give this card a color, and color of primary. Why? Because I love this color. Here is our primary color, and now I think you can clearly see the boundaries of the card. This is our card. This is our card. This is the card subtitle. It is a bit shorter in size. The card title is bigger, and this is the iron content. These title and subtitle are inside an iron card header. So let's go to the next example and see what else it has. So in this next example, the iron card has no iron header and no subtitle or title. It has got an iron item. Let me just again copy and paste it. And let me remove the old one, because I don't want to have a complicated UI inside my code, so that it would be easy for you to understand. And let me go to the, let me save it. And I saved the wrong thing. Let me control S. And this is a new card. As you can see, it contains an icon here and some text here. And all these things are coming from this code. This is the icon, this is a label, then there is a button, icon, label and button. Now this is the content. So it's okay, we can put it means that we can put different type of things inside an iron card. Let's take this example now. This is the third example. Let me replace the old one. I paste it here. Control shift and I to format the code. It's already formatted. Let me save our code and see, this is the third example, and it's quite good actually. See, there is a bottom border and an elevation feeling that we are getting, and this shadow border actually. So iron card gives us a lot of CSS inbuilt inside it, so we don't have to do CSS work while using iron card. See, there is only ionic markup and nothing else. So I hope you get the idea of what an iron card is. Let's use the first one, because it is the standard that is most used of the time, most of the time. Let me copy it, let me replace this one, and let's save it. And our ionic application will be rendered again. And let's learn about some of the properties of iron card. So button, if true, button tag will be rendered and the card will be tappable. Okay, so this button property we have already learnt in iron items. I will do it once again here. See, at present this card is not clickable, not tappable. So what we can do, we can give it an attribute of button. And if I save it, then now our card is tappable. See, a hand icon is coming up, hand pointer is coming up, which means it's now tappable, right? So we can also attach some functionality to it. The second is the color, and the color could be anything, and we already gave the color once. We can do it once again. Let me give a color. This time I will give it a color of danger, and the danger color is red, and the card is now red. So there are 9 different colors. You can play with all of them, but I think we are done with it. and disabled, well, we can now deduce what does disabled mean. It may mean that we will get a visual indication that the card is disabled. If I put disabled and save it, now you can see that it is faded, the card is faded, and now nothing is happening. We can't click it and we can't interact with it. It means that it is now disabled. Let's go to the next property, download, and this attribute inserts. Again, this we have computed in an item. What it means is if there is an href, let me give an href to be an image, and we have an image in assets folder, that is image underscore 01.jpg, and if I now click on this card, our image 01.jpg will open in a different tab, okay, or in the same tab actually. So let me go back, and if I give it an attribute of download, now what will happen is this image will not open, and download, if we give download attribute to card, then the URL specified in href will be open to save or open, right? Will be, we can download the URL that is specified in the href attribute. So this is download, and href is again, if we need to navigate to some other page or to some other URL, we will use href attribute inside the IN card UI component. Mode, okay, this is the mode. By default everything is in MD mode, and if we want we can change the mode and see the difference. So let it be, this is the mode, let me, okay, if the mode is MD, this is the default mode. I hope nothing changes, and nothing changes. Let me give it a mode of iOS, and it will change. Okay, so this is how the rendering of the IN card will be done if we give the mode iOS. Otherwise by default it is the MD mode, and for MD mode we don't need to specify anything because it is by default. And if we just go scroll REL and router and router direction, guys, all these things are related to routing, and we will take this topic routing in a different video. Why? Because these properties are common to a lot of elements. Yes, they were also present in case of IN items, they are also present in IN cards. So I will be taking up a different video, and when I am going to make that video, I will put the description in the link. Oh, sorry, I will put the link in the description box. Just some fumble, I'm sorry. And let's move, and I think it's complete now. Okay, so it's completed now, and now I think we know what an IN card is, and I think we should build our product descriptions page with the help of this IN card. What we need, and this is the layout that we need in our product description page. We have got a header here, there is, I think we can make this header. Let's start doing it actually. Keep this in our mind, and let me remove all the other things. And what we'll do, we need a product description here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just put some default content here. And let the product description is okay, let it be. So here we need Duracell AA batteries, and as this I think it is IN title, IN card title. So let me put this IN card title. I don't know why it is recommended to put IN card title after IN subtitle. Maybe they just wanted to show the difference. IN card title, let me just put here the name of the product, name of the product. Okay, let me give type of the product, I think that's done. And now this is an image, So what I think, let's put an ion image here. Ion, IMG, and give it a source, and let's use our assets image 01.jpg. I think we have done a lot of things. Let's test whether we have achieved something or not. Okay, wow. Okay, product description is here. The name of the product, same font, product type is also there. The image is also the same. And now we need a price and then some more content. So let me use some labels here now. Let me use two items actually. Iron item and then an iron label and again an iron item. Let me just pause the video for a second. Okay guys, welcome back, and this is what we have prepared till now, and it's good that we have come so close to what we wanted. Now we need two more labels, and now what I'm going to use here is a double braces to display the price. Why? I could have displayed it without the help of double braces, but I am using it because I wanted to show you something. Because in the last video we missed a thing, we had to display the currency along with the price, and that's what we are going to do here. We are going to use a pipe operator and use the currency property so that there will be dollar. As you can see, dollar is displayed here along with 5.49, and this dollar is coming from the pipe operator and the currency variable. And there is a small line, so let me set the lines as none. The same thing we are going to do in the next item as well. And let me put a label. I think the label we are having here, we can use it to test this item label, and let's now save it and let's now see. Okay, I think we got what we wanted, only that the item, the label is not clearly visible. So we can use here iron text wrap property or yeah, and I think okay guys, so I think we have achieved what we wanted. Our target UI is now achieved. This is the UI that we wanted, and now we have achieved it. So guys, thanks for watching this video, and stay tuned for the next, where we are going to actually fetch the data over the API with the help of this ID and display it in this card. Thanks for watching. See you in the next.